Dallas Cowboys and the Los Angeles Rams. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Rams team as they interplay. It's been a lost first month of the season, that's for sure, as they come in with an 0-4 record.
And the window's not shut on them, though. They still have a chance to make something out of this season, but it has to start right now.
Meanwhile, for the visitors here, the Cowboys, they were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it 2 in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense.
And we are underway from SoFi Stadium. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Dak Prescott and Dallas taking the field for their first possession. Dak now in his seventh season in charge of the Cowboys. Two-time Pro Bowler.
You know what I did in pregame? I made sure I touched him as he went by. I want a little bit of what he's got.
The golden arm from last week.
Oh, how much fun was that to watch that game tape, all right? The number of touchdowns, that was at five last week.
Yeah.
But zero interceptions. So you think he's due to throw a pick, but I'm betting they continue the streak in this game.
5 yards on the game's first play, second down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. On third down, it's Prescott. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. To the air again, Prescott. Got it open, man. It's Michael Gallup. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. Really a solid start here on the opening drive, Charles. He's now 4-4, and they're already in plus territory.
Brandon, he's been so precise to start this game, like we're watching an operation taking place right now. Master surgeon at work.
Meanwhile, Prescott's throw complete into the hands of Schultz here. And the tackle going to be made at the 38. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 5 catches, 59 yards, and a touchdown.
And he was able to haul that pass in there, but he knows he's got a tough task ahead of him. This unit in the top 5 in the NFL against the pass. He's going to have to really work hard to get open.
Prescott yet again. And that one into the hands of Washington downfield. Touchdown, Cowboys! James Washington, his second touchdown on the season. And the Cowboys are on the board first on the road here in L.A. point tacked on by Lambeau, and it's now a 7-0 game. So that drives 6 plays, 75 yards. And it's James Washington who finishes things with a touchdown reception. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. Now here comes the Los Angeles offense and the man in charge of it in his second season with the team, 14th overall in what's been an impressive career, Matthew Stafford. A quick throw now complete to Ross. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Second down and 8. Now the first carry for Cam Akers. And he's upended after a gain of 4 up to the 25-yard line. And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. From the gun, here's Stafford. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. And you get the sense, as I'm sure they got the sense, they might have picked up a good one here, maybe a little diamond in the rough via trade.
Maybe just need a change in scenery, a new city, maybe different motivation, but they believe they've got a good one.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And the Rams at a disappointing 0-4 through the first month of the year. It's been really a lost first month of the season. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Lambeau on for the extra point. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Fields it right around the goal line. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
So the Rams coming back onto the field, their second drive of the game. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. He rifles. Accepted. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense. Touchdown. Lambeau to add on the extra point. It's good, and before you know it, it's 21-0. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six.
This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. He is off to an unfathomable start, throwing the football, throwing the two passes, both been intercepted and returned for touchdowns. We'll see how he bounces back. It's first and 10.
Stafford here, coming off his pick six. And here's another interception, the third of this first quarter. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line. Following the interception, here's Prescott. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes inbounds. That'll give them eight that time, and they'll be left with second and a couple. Prescott off play action. Open man downfield is Lamb. It's complete. Touchdown, Cowboys. CeeDee Lamb, 37 yards. And the Cowboys are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Boy, CeeDee, what a start for them. Still in the first quarter, they're absolutely blitzing them. All the points that they put up, I'm not sure what you say on the other sideline right now.
I think it's as simple as this, partner. The way that they're playing, there's no limits on what this lead could become.
Lambeau on for the extra point. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. Pretty clean and simple there. Just two plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number two. Taking it about the one. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. And now this offense comes back out onto the field. And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football, and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
Now a throw here to his running back, and he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. They'll try and run for this with Akers. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 11 and a first down, L.A. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard.
It's all right, man. Cool. I've been going there like deposit. You don't really brag about it when you know you got it. Real hard to read it, need hooked on phonics. Say a lot of things and never catch like Sonic. Zone, I'm gone. When I'm in my zone, and get it going, Donkey Kong. They got the hand out of where you give a dog a bone. I'm like, oh, no, you got to get it on your own. They get an attitude, I'm like, you better check your tone. They ain't got no job, need someone to take it home. I hop up in the car, whip like Indiana Jones. Going George Lucas, now I'm out here killing clones. Coming in strong, like, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down. Boosted up my cardio, I used to get the run around. I've been doing this since I had to work at Mama House. Woo! Tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down. Everybody eating, it's a party when I come to town. You can bring your mama, daddy, sister, and your cousin out. Kill the king, like shit, wanna take the crown. I can see through it like a stomach with a ultrasound sign. When I hit the gas, I be going like 100 miles. They be getting tired, running out like 100 house. All up in my business, real nose like a bloodhound. I'ma throw them off like I'm standing on a pitcher mound. All they do is look at Instagram while they sit around. Hate me in real life, but you liking pictures now. Oh, everybody acting different now. Finally trying to see what I be on. Got a different style, they be at the brand new. When they know I been around, got a fake smile on your face, cause you been inclined. I can say a lot, but I'm not. Gotta keep it down, making sure nobody drown. I'm a brother, keep it now. Mike Jack hit me up and said I gotta beat it down. Turn me up when I'm on your speaker now. Cool, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down. Boosted up my cardio, I used to get the run around. I've been doing this since I had to work at Mama House. Tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down.
it's a party, one o'clock time. You can bring your mama, daddy, sister, and your cousin out. Yeah, you in the lead, but you ain't hooping around and tearing out. Before you judge me, you need to go and wipe the mirror off. Try to turn me down, the only thing you do is veer off. Showing fake love, I can tell it once I see it all. I just stay cool, acting like it wasn't weird at all. Most of the people that you meet are not who they appeared at. If you want on top, then you wouldn't hear it cheer it all. But I ain't got no top, I don't need a chandelier at all. I ain't got no time, cause I be really out my mind. When the hate don't work, I guarantee to get the line. They all talk, dog, it's a room full of brines. I'm red, T, that means that it's in my bloodline. All hell, the king made the president resign. And if I'm not the king, then I'm making doves cry. I'm stepping on the scene like I never did reply. I ain't gotta justify, I'm cool. Tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down. Boosted on my cardio, I used to get the run around. I've been doing this since I had to work at mama house. Tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down. Everybody eating, it's a party, one o'clock. You can bring your mama, daddy, sister, and your cousin out.
More than his last game, a 5-touchdown effort. It's the Cowboys and the Rams, and it's coming right up on EA Sports.
It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Today, we've got a good Week 5 matchup in store here between the Dallas Cowboys and the Los Angeles Rams. Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, you look at this Rams team as they interplay. They come into this one knowing it's been a while since tasting victory. They've dropped 4 in a row.
Can they remember what it was like to win a game? In these types of situations, you're looking for someone to inspire you, and it doesn't have to be one of your best players either.
Meanwhile, for the visitors here, the Cowboys, they were winners last time out, so that. We go from SoFi Stadium. And we will not see a run back on the opening kickoff. This will be a touchback. The Cowboys taking the field on offense, and for a 7th season, it's Dak Prescott who brings him out.
And not only was it great to see Dak Prescott make his return in 2021, it's even better to see him playing the best ball of his career. He didn't lead Dallas to just a division title and its best record in 6 years. Dallas also led the league in yards and points, the first time it has led in both since 1971.
And the Rams got him. They bring him down. The sack by Jordan Willis.
CD, you know, so often we talk about quarterbacks holding on to the ball too long. Well, we can't say that there. He had no time to do much of anything.
Yeah, that's when we turn to your line and say, guys, can I get a little help here? And you have to ask politely because, remember, they're blocking for you the entire game. But as a quarterback, you've also got to have the clock running in your head when you need to get rid of the football. But this time, he had no chance. They were on him instantly.
Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete. On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. This will be fielded at the 17. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. And here comes Matthew Stafford leading the Rams offense out there, just as he did last season when he captured his first and the Rams' second Super Bowl title. They'll begin on the ground with Akers. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. The numbers for him from a week ago, a boatload of carries, 128 yards, and a touchdown.
I think he's exactly where he wants to be coming into a game, partner, because he has to still be riding the momentum from last week when he broke the century mark in rushing and had one of his best individual efforts of the season. I would expect that there's more from him on the way after that type of a game, and I know his teammates and coaches, they feel exactly the same way.
On third down, here's a run by Akers. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Give him the third down conversion. 5 yards on the play. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. And the Rams had a disappointing 0-4 through the first month of the year. And they come into this one knowing it's been a while since they've had a W. They have dropped 4 in a row.
Let me tell you, when you go a month, partner, in this league, without a victory, it gets tough to come to work every day. And in addition, you start to wonder about your job security as well.
And his throw here is incomplete.
Perfect example of the kind of attitude you have to play defensive back in the NFL. You want to be the only defender around, and you want them to challenge you. And on that play, he came through.
Throwing on third down, Stafford. Got a man open, it's Tyler Higbee. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Stafford going to give this to Akers. And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Going right back to Akers. And he's got this pretty close to a first down at the Cowboys 37. 9th play coming up here on this drive. This is 3rd and a yard. And he's going to get to the 31. Enough for the first down. It's a pickup of 6. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. They'll run on first down with Akers. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's 2nd down. Here's a run with Akers on 2nd down. And only 1 yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. From the gun on 3rd down, Stafford. And that is too far out in front of his intended target. Incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps to have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell us end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number 1. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
After after the made field goal. Gay back out there to kick it off. This one will come out to the 25 as Pollard is going to elect not to return it. Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
A quick first down pickup. Good start after going three and out on their opening drive. Well, you don't become a two-time rushing champion in this league without being able to shed some tackles, and Ezekiel Elliott does just that on this latest run.
Yeah, and this could be a sign of what this defense is in for, because you know all week long the coaches were preaching to the defense, you've got to be able to wrap up against a back like him, or he can make you pay. Technique, technique, technique.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Up the middle. Here's Elliott. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40.
41 yards rushing for him now on just his first three carries.
So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Meanwhile, Dak's throw pulled in by Lamb.
And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 11 more on that one and another first down. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Prescott down. Buying time to his left. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Dak Prescott with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year.
And the Cowboys have moved out in front.
Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. That time, 75-yard drive, five plays.
And it was all capped off by Dak Prescott, keeping it and taking it in on the touchdown run. Fields it right around the goal line. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. Cam Akers and the Rams offense ready to go back to work.
Whatever he was doing in September, they're hoping that that carries over now to October, because he was sensational last month.
He absolutely was, and we all know where it started. At the end of last season, right? All the offseason preparation, the weight workouts, the sprints, right? The vision that he had, what he was going to do this season. And, of course, it all came together with the rest of the team. Those big fellas up front, leverage, and, boy, are they getting downfield creating extra blocks for him.
They really are. Everyone's been doing their job so far to create those holes. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down L.A.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace and change direction, that's often the end result.
They'll go again here with Akers.
And he's got some space here. And they've got it well across midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
On the handoff, running left is Akers. He'll get this down to the 38.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about where they take it.
And the pressure gets to him and brings him down. Stafford is sacked.
That's Anthony Barr coming in from his linebacker spot to bring him to the ground.
Now that's a heck of a moment for your first sack of the game, because if this long drive ends without a touchdown because of that sack, we're going to look back and say that might be one of the biggest plays of this contest.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 21 yards there. A big play on fourth down.
They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10.
And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
No daylight for him to run through there, and he ran into the defensive tackle, and that guy blocks a whole lot of daylight as it is. He is truly a big man who just made a big play.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Off the fake to Akers. Here's Stafford. That's caught left side. It's Higbee, the tight end. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
This offense so far on third down, they've converted three out of five thus far. They're up against a third and one situation. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. And it appears we've got a member of the Rams shaken up on that last play.
Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They'll go with Akers here up the middle.
And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10.
75 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. From the shotgun, here's a give to Akers.
And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. Stafford. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Another good drive, Charles, but it looks like another that might end in a field goal try.
They've made some nice plays. They've given themselves opportunities, but as you noted, another field goal attempt coming up. And that's not how they want to end drives. They've got to figure out what's the final touch that they need to push it across the goal line.
Yeah, still yet to find the end zone. And the Rams are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They'll run here with Akers.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Stafford barking out signals and trying to get his guys set quickly. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. Now Stafford on third and goal. Touchdown! Van Jefferson. His first touchdown on the year. And the Rams have regained the lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead is now 10-7. So that, amazingly, a 17-play drive.
And it was all capped off by the Van Jefferson touchdown reception.
After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away.
Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Coming up in prime time here in Week 5, a couple of division rivalries on the docket, beginning tonight in the AFC North with the Bengals and Ravens from Baltimore at 8:20 Eastern. Then tomorrow, Monday Night Football, Raiders and Chiefs from Arrowhead in the AFC West.
They start on the ground with Elliott. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
And he finds his target. It's Schultz. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
Dalton Schultz really built on his 2020 when he seized the Cowboys' starting job in 2021. 78 catches, were third in the league for tight ends. He's locked himself in as one of the Cowboys' main pieces on offense. They'll go to him every chance they get when he makes first down catches like that.
First down throw for Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. From just shy of midfield, Prescott back to Elliott, and he's got him again. And he is going to lose yardage here. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. They'll throw again. Prescott eluding the pressure right. And that is incomplete. Well, the other day they told us when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had. Thought they could exploit them. Unable to do so on that play. Let's go old school there. That's absolutely a great coffin corner punt. Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops where they place them and try and put them there. Now a lot of guys use barrels on the sidelines to try and put the football in one.
Message received here. No need to wait. We're going to skip halftime and get right back to the action. Here comes the third quarter. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Rams going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. So here are the Rams to take over. They've dropped four straight games coming into this one, remember, but they have the lead here. Stafford and the Rams come up first and 10 at their own 24. He starts with a give to Akers, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Throwing a Stafford. One, but incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. ...51 yards on the punt there. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half.
Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive.
On play action, Prescott. Left side to Lamb. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
Well, this is an awfully tough route to defend in man coverage because he lines up on the right and runs a crossing route back to the other side of the field. So as a defender, you're not only trailing him the whole way, you're also looking out for your own guys to make sure you don't get yourself picked off. And then you can't catch up in time to prevent the completion.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
The goal is certainly to try and make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Here's Prescott. escaping the pressure right. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation.
Oh, partner, just a second earlier, and they might have had him because they certainly thought they were going to close in and drop him behind the line of scrimmage, but he had just enough time to dodge the pressure, and he ends up getting yardage before being stopped.
And this is caught, but I don't think he stayed in bounds. No, he didn't. It's incomplete. The throw took him past the boundary, and it's fourth. Anger is on to punt, and he gets this one away. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. Second down, they'll go with Akers again. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of six. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll run out of the gun with Akers. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Someone's been having a good game so far. You know something? A lot has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. They give up the middle to Akers. And he's going to get a solid gain of nine before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. On the give, this is Akers. And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. On the handoff, it's Akers. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time. Back now here on EA Sports. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter.
They'll run for it with Akers.
And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. Sean McVay's gamble does not pay off. And the Cowboys defense is going to get him the football back. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 46.
He'll hand it off to Elliott to begin the drive.
And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Looking to throw, Prescott.
He'll get this out wide here to Elliott.
And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys. Here's Prescott. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. A'shawn Robinson, too much to handle that time, gets the sack. On second down, Elliott. Just a yard there, so it brings up a tough third and 12.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Open man, Lamb. It's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Inside give to Elliott. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
When he runs, he seems to do a nice job of knowing when to be patient and find the hole. And then when the hole is there, he goes quickly.
You're exactly right. He knows how to just take off. But you know what else? Brings a little thump with him, doesn't he?
He does.
He packs the boom at the end of the run and finishes it going forward. That's what you want to see out of your backs.
It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Elliott will get down close to the goal line, but not in, as he'll be marked down at the one. Third and goal. This L.A. Rams defense will try to bow up once more. Prescott. And this ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas. A one-yard touchdown pass. And the Cowboys have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. Extra point tacked on by Lambeau. And the lead is now 14-10. That time, a nine-play drive.
And it's finished off by the touchdown from CeeDee Lamb.
Taken at the goal line. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. This offense back out and set to go for their next drive. And now they'll look to answer working from behind. And remember, this offense has sputtered, yet to score here in the second half. They'll need to change that here. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On first down, they'll stay with Akers on the ground. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. Going right back to Akers. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. They'll try and run for this with Akers. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Stafford going to give this to Akers. And he'll be brought down right on the 50. A gain of 3. Stafford barking out signals and trying to get his guys set quickly. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
It makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Clock continuing to roll as the Rams try to get going again. Desperation time for Stafford on fourth down. And he fires one that's intercepted. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
Well, that second half, Charles, a little bit different from the first. Not only did